Yeah!
Hey guys, this is RyzoraNinja, and today we have something a little bit different. We have an unboxing here, as you can see. I should be unboxing these right now. So let's start with the first one. This one is the biggest one, obviously. Alright, so. Oh, would you look at that? Looky here. Got the QJ floppy cube. Oh yeah. So let's look at that one first. Just open this, ruining the boxing here. So, obviously, it is a 1x3x3, as you can see here. 1x3x3. And let's see how it moves. Appears to be a little fragile, but you would expect that from a 1x3x3. As you can see, it does have shape-shifting abilities. If we go like this, and then like that, see, it can shape-shift like that. Obviously, don't want to shape-shift too much here, since I don't know how to solve it yet. We'll just put that back, and that looks pretty good. So, not sure if we can lube that. I don't think we can, but, oh well. Okay, so that was the QJ. Moves, it's pretty fragile, obviously, but seems like it's solvable, obviously. So, there's the QJ 1x3x3, also known as the floppy cube. So you see the QJ logo there with a little thing there. And then nothing on the back. So let's get to the next one. Our next one. Opening it here. Put that over there. Is the Xing Xiao 5x5. First moves on it. Oh, very nice. Oh, it does very nice here, doesn't it? Look at this. This moves so nice. It moves so smoothly. Look at that. That's just fantastic. That's how a puzzle should move. Look at that. Let's see if we can corner cut. Nope. Okay, no corner cutting. Well, let's see. Let's put it right here. Yep, it can corner cut a very minimal amount, but you really don't need corner cutting on a 5x5, so just show it again here. Has very minimal. That's all you will need, especially since the 5x5 algorithms don't exactly require that much. I like the clunky feeling of it. It's very nice. As you can see, just kind of go like that. Very nice. So, let me just put this back here. And we will get on to our next one. So, our next one, if I cannot mutilate the box here, is the... that over there. This is the Xing Xiao 4x4. And my goodness... is it quite lubed? Ooh, it turns very nice. I like that. Turns very good. Very good control. Very good. This thing feels oily, though. I mean, look at that. You can almost see the oil, the slickness of it when they had to do that. So it looks very nice. Can't wait to start solving it. Obviously. Looks very good. See the layers, all of them. Yeah, all of them turn very smoothly. It's very nice. So I would definitely recommend both of these Xing Xiaos here. So just as a size comparison, here is a 3x3 next to the 5x5. As you can see, the 5x5 is obviously going to be bigger. This is a Daihan Guhan And it's quite a big size difference. Not a huge one, obviously, it's just a little bit bigger. Give you a different angle here, so that way you can actually see the actual thing here. And then here it is next to a 4x4. Even more minimal. See, the gap is much smaller than that one. That's about a half a cube. That one's about a quarter cube bigger. As far on this side, at least. And then, if we just bring our little handy-dandy 2x2 here, you can see that it is a full cube higher. A full row of cubes higher. And then here, it is only... Actually, it's 3/4 cubes higher. Very surprised at that. This is... just a land here, as you can see, just like that. Definitely recommend this to anyone. I would not recommend this cube, however. It has a popping problem. Still moves very nice. Can do minimal corner cutting for what you need it to do. As you can see, it can almost go line to line with no problem. But you really don't need... See, you can just kind of go like that. But, yeah. Anyway. So, that's that. So, here, again, there's the 1x3x3. Very fragile. Very, very fragile. What's holding these together? Is a magnet holding these together? I actually think that's might be what is holding these together. I'm scared to take it apart, though. But, oh well. So... we have our next box here, which is the QJ 2x3x3. And here, as you can see, it's bundled up very nicely here. Very odd the way they bundled this, but, you know, whatever they want to do. Ooh, very nice. That's very nice. So, if we can get it out of here. Handy dandy scissors again. And we take it out. And let's see how it moves. So, it definitely needs some lubrication. This obviously has shape shifting. Ooh, yeah, that needs some serious lubrication. As you can see, it's quite hard to move the other way for some... Oh, never mind. There we go. Oh, it's moving a lot better now. It's weird. Why does it get locked up at certain spots here? Oh, there we go. That's weird. Yeah, definitely need some lubrication. As you can see, this also has the... shape-shifting effect here, if I can get it to do it. Actually, I might not be able to get this one to do it. Can this shape-shift? Actually, I don't think this can... I'm probably wrong, but... So you got the QJ logo here, got the normal sticker layout, as you can see. A little disappointed by how it moved at first there. That was kind of weird how it locked up on me, but it moves fine now. The outer layers are a little clunky. Same as the QJ. Very fragile as well. But looks pretty good. I'll have quite a lot of fun playing with it. I still don't know if it can shapeshift. I'm actually not sure if it can. It doesn't seem like it can at this exact moment, but I could be completely wrong. I might start playing with it and see that it can. Let's try one more time. Yeah, because that's not going to move that, so... But anyway. So that is that. And then, our last package here. Rubiks. My Rubik's Cube lubricant. Very nice. This is going to be used... You got the little thing that came with it. So we got a Rubik's sticker, as you can see. Very nice. Anything else in here? Just that. Alrighty. Now we open this and we put the little thing on there, which is what you use when you're actually moving cubes. So we get this and we put it on like so. If I can figure out how to do it. Don't think I'm going to be able to figure this out. Nope, doesn't go in that way for sure. Wait. I think I'm just derping. But I don't know how to put this in.
Oh well. Then no matter. But this is going to use for this. A Daihan Zanchi. I'm making my own Daihan Zanchi, so you got the cord, you got all the screws. Came with stickers as well. That'll do it for this unboxing, guys. Be sure to tune in on my channel for more unboxings such as these. And I hope you all have a wonderful day. Thanks so much for watching.